Hello friends, this is a time for practice. Today I'll have top 10 questions on English regarding pedagogy, a pedagogy of teaching English. Now you are in front of the examination hall or TET 2019. And Vidyastu Education is here to help you. Friends, in English, you will face 30 questions. 10 questions on comprehension. Two paragraphs or two passages. One is prose, another is poetry. 10 questions. Another 10 questions from English pedagogy. How to teach English in elementary schools. And another 10 questions are from language items, which we call its grammar. So today I'll tell you the cause of the correctness of the answer, why this answer is correct or wrong. So please be with me for the whole video to complete. See all the 10 questions. I'm sure you will not find the answer of 10 question only, you will get the knowledge of attempting 100 questions if you listen it, watch it properly. So friends, first question for you. Language has four major skills, we know. Which skill is the multilingual skill? Listening, speaking, reading and writing. Now you can guess the answer. Can you tell me the right answer? Let's see the right answer. Right answer is reading. Why reading is multilingual? Because here you have to have eye-hand coordination. You have to understand the script. Again, there will be picture in your mind. So you are using multilingual skills or all skills here at a time. You are watching, you are again finding the scripts, again structure of the letters, etc. A lot of things you have to see. Therefore, reading is called as multilingual skill. Question number two. Reading is primarily intended for dash. Option are A. Guessing, B. Pronunciation, C. Comprehension and D. None of the above. Reading is primarily intended for dash. Can you guess the answer please? Okay, the answer is comprehension. Basically, why we read? We always not to read the guess the meaning. We always read the text or story or poem for pronunciation. So our purpose is to understand the text, whether it's a story or it's a poem, our purpose is to understand it. Therefore, comprehension or understanding is the answer. The answer is C. Question number three. Reading aloud mostly focus on dash. We know. The options are pronunciation, reading with speed, comprehension, none of these. Friends, you know, reading is of two types, reading aloud and silent reading. Here I am talking about reading aloud. What it focuses on? Can you guess the meaning? Guess the answer, please. The answer is pronunciation. If your pronunciation is appropriate. So the first and foremost objective of reading aloud is pronunciation. And the objective of silent reading or reading silent is meaning, comprehension. So the answer is A. Silent reading helps in dash. Options are reading with speed, developing good spelling, comprehension, both A and C. Can you guess the meaning? Guess the answer, please. ओके, व्हाट इज द आंसर? इट्स बोथ ए एंड वी, ए एंड सी, रीडिंग विथ स्पीड एंड कॉम्प्रिहेंशन. दैट मीन्स व्हेन यू आर रीडिंग ए टेक्स्ट यू आर ट्राइंग टू गेट द मीनिंग ऑफ दैट टेक्स्ट एंड ऑल्सो यू हैव टू रीड द पैसेज स्पीड. इफ यू कैनॉट स्पीड, यू कैनॉट रीड स्पीड, यू विल बी स्लोअर देन अदर्स. सो बोथ स्पीड एंड कॉम्प्रिहेंशन इज अवर मोटो. हियर वी डू नॉट फोकस ऑन व्हाट इज द स्पेलिंग. आई एम टेलिंग यू ऑल द ऑप्शंस विल बी लाइक इक्वली इम्पोर्टेंट फॉर द क्वेश्चन, बट प्लीज फोकस ऑन विच इज मोस्ट इम्पोर्टेंट. डायरेक्टली प्रोपोर्शनल वेदर और नॉट. देन क्वेश्चन नंबर 5, स्कैनिंग इज अ स्ट्रेटेजी ऑफ साइलेंट रीडिंग, व्हाई इज इट मीन्ट फॉर? व्हाट इज द पर्पस ऑफ स्कैनिंग? गेटिंग द जिस्ट, लोकेटिंग स्पेसिफिक इंफॉर्मेशन, बोथ ए एंड बी, नॉन ऑफ द अबव. कैन यू गेस द मीनिंग प्लीज? कैन यू गेस द आंसर? नो? ओके, सी द आंसर. Locating specific information. Suppose you are going to Delhi. You have booked a ticket. You are waiting on the station. There is a reservation list. You are not reading all the names. You are just finding your name. Like when you are finding the phone number of your friend in telephone directory, you are just getting the specific information. So this is called scanning. Okay. Question number 6. Another strategy is skimming, and skimming is dash. What is the meaning of skimming? Making a gist of the text, locating the specific information, guessing the meaning, pronouncing the words correctly. What will be the answer? Please guess. The answer is making a gist of the text. So when scanning is meant to locate the specific information, skimming is meant for making a gist of the text. It's a strategy of reading. Suppose you are reading a story, suppose you are reading a newspaper, you are just trying to get the gist of the text. That is called skimming. Please remember scanning and skimming. Chunking refers to dash, reading with speed, making sense groups, correct pronunciation, none of this. What is chunking? You have to understand that. So can you guess the answer please? The answer is making sense groups. Chunking means when you are reading a story, you are dividing the story into different sense groups. It's not exactly one way of reading, you are dividing it a part, then sub part, then part. That is called chunking, and that chunking helps you to read the text and understand step by step. Having the same meaning, the similar meaning, we divide it as one, then another similar steps or similar meaning or similar fact, it is sense group para. We call it as a sense group para. Okay. Then question number 8. A person with a poor eye span dash cannot comprehend, cannot scan, cannot read with speed, none of these. What is the answer? This is the answer. That means a person with a poor eye span cannot read with speed. If your eye span is poor, eye span, what do you mean by eye span? Eye span means reading the words in a time period, during how much time you are taking to read. Suppose in 1 minute, how much words you can read. That is called eye span in 1 minute. So that poor eye span will just break your speed reading. Okay, so try to expand your eye span always. Question number 9. सब वोकलाइजेशन हिंडर्स. सब वोकलाइजेशन मीन्स व्हेन यू आर रीडिंग एट दैट टाइम यू आर मेकिंग सम मर्मरिंग साउंड. व्हाट इज द ऑप्शन? रीडिंग स्पीड, कॉम्प्रिहेंशन, चंकिंग, ऑल ऑफ द अबव. दैट मीन्स व्हेन यू आर रीडिंग ए टेक्स्ट यू आर मेकिंग सम गुणुगुणु गुणुगुणु मर्मरिंग साउंड्स. सो इट व्हाट इट हिंडर्स, इट हिंडर्स ऑल ऑफ द अबव. That means you cannot read speedily. Your eye span will be less. You cannot comprehend the meaning of the text. That subvocalization will disturb you to find the meaning. And if you cannot make it chunking or chunk it or make it different sense group para, then it will be difficult for you to get the meaning properly. Therefore, subvocalization hinders reading. Reading speed, comprehension and chunking. The answer is all of the above. Question number 10. Finger pointing in reading is a bad habit. It leads to poor eye span, poor chunking, poor stress, none of these. Can you guess the answer? See, this is the answer. When a child will read with his finger, many of the students do that. This is my bat, like this. Just under the sentence, the child is pointing his finger. And that will just diminish or decrease your eye span. Therefore, do not allow the students to read the word by word pointing their fingers, please. What is chunking? You have understood. What is stress? Stress means when we give focus on word or syllable or sentence, that is called stress. So that stress is not the answer. The answer is it leads to poor eye span. Friends, I have discussed only 10 questions, but during my discussions, I have given a lot of tips to you to understand or to get through other questions also. You just watch this video again and again. I am sure you will find so many answers from these questions. I have found 10 very, very important questions which is related to others also. And if you understand this video, these 10 questions, I am sure you can answer 100 questions. Okay? So see this and watch this video again and again. Try to find the meaning and try to relate the all these options and questions other areas also. So friends, in the next episode, I'll give you 10 questions on writing. So what is the importance of this? What is the typical area of this episode? All the 10 questions were from reading. You see, all the 10 questions from reading skill. And in the next episode, I'll discuss 10 questions on writing. So for this episode, thank you very much. Be a lot, be happy. Always have your faith, have your belief that English is easy. Don't worry. English is very easy. If you focus on that, you will succeed. Thank you very much.